Good afternoon, class. Today we will be continuing with the operators. Yesterday we have seen what was a logical operator, unary operator, and in the logical operators we have seen the types of operators like AND, OR, and NOT. Before starting up with the shorthand operator, once you revise the logical operators, because many of them had some confusion in the logical operators. So first we clear up the logical operators and then go with the shorthand operators. So yesterday the logical operators, I said you have three types, that is logical, and second one is logical or, and third one is logical not. So these are the three logical operators, AND, OR, and NOT. AND is given with the symbol in this way, it is called as ampersand. Okay, then OR is given with two lines, and NOT is given with the operator x might be mal. So these are the operators given, these are the symbols given for AND, OR, and NOT. So first coming to the AND operator, here I have told logical operators means which combines two relational operators. Okay, logical operator will combine two relational operators. In that, first we'll see what is an AND operator. In the AND operator, whenever you are taking two inputs or any number of inputs, okay, if you are taking two inputs or any number of inputs, for example, here I am taking two inputs. If you are taking both the inputs as true, yesterday I told true will be given the value 1 and false will be given the value 0. Okay, true is given by 1 and false is given with the value 0. So here, if both the inputs are true, only then you will get the output as true. Is it clear? If both the inputs are true, then the output is true. Either any one of the input is false, then the output will be false. Okay, understood? When two inputs are true, the output will be true. Either any one of the case is false, then the output will be false. This is an AND operator. Coming to the OR operator, it is just the vice versa. Here I am taking an example for only two inputs. Here in the OR operator, if both the inputs are false, the output will be false. In the OR operator, this is OR and this is AND. In the OR operator, if both the inputs are false, then the output is false. Either any one of the input is true, okay, either if any one of the input is true, then the output is also true. Now understand the difference. In the AND operator, if both the inputs are true, the output will be true. Either any one case is false, the answer will be false. Here, if both the inputs are false, then the output will be false. If either any one is true, then it is considered as the true output. This is the AND and OR. Coming to the NOT. NOT is nothing but an inverter. NOT is nothing but an inverter. If you are taking the value as true, it gives the result as false. If you are taking the input as false, it gives the result as true. I will take one example and explain all these things. So for example, if you are taking 10 is greater than 9, and if 10 is equal to 10. So this is my example for AND operator. When I am writing this symbol, it means it is an AND operator. See how it works. 10 is greater than 9. Individually you take 10 is greater than 9. This is true. True means what I have to take? The value as 1. And 10 is equal to 10. This is also true. So what is the condition here? True and true. So in the AND operator, if both the inputs are true, the output will be true here. Is this clear? This is the AND operator. The same example, if you are taking for OR operator, then true for OR and true here. Then here, if it if both are true, then the answer is true here. This is and or. Whereas if you are taking not, consider a single example. If 5 is greater than or equal to, 5 is greater than 9, the actual answer is false here. So false means I am taking the value as 0. So here, if you are, if an operator is mentioned here, not of 5 greater than 9, then the answer we have to consider is 1. Okay, then we have to consider the answer as 1 because we have the operator not here. This is the not logical operator. Now I think it is understood. This is the and or and not for logical operators. And I have explained unary operators, where unary operators act on single variable. In that we have two types, increment operator and decrement operator. Then next we have something called as shorthand operator. The next one we have is shorthand operator. The next one is shorthand operator. The name itself is mentioning here. Shorthand means here if you are taking any one expression. So suppose if you think the expression is x is equals to x plus 5. This is an expression. Now, to reduce this length of an expression, we are making use of shorthand operator and we are reducing the length of an expression here. The expression actually is x is equals to x plus 5. To reduce this length in the shorthand operator, we are writing it as x plus is equals to 5. Okay, this is the method of writing using shorthand operators. In the shorthand operators, we are making use of arithmetic operators only, that is plus, minus, multiplication, division and modulus. In the shorthand operator, we are making use of arithmetic operators plus, minus, multiplication, division and modulus. But along with this, we are writing an equal to symbol. It is nothing but assignment operator. Is nothing but called as assignment operator. So using these shorthand operator symbols, we are going to reduce the length of an expression. We are going to reduce the length of an expression. For example, suppose I am writing A is equals to A plus B, or it is A is equals to A plus 10. These are our expressions. These expressions have to be reduced to a smaller length. How you write this expression is, first you have two variables here. Consider the variable only once, A, and what operator is written, write that operator, then equal to symbol along with the constant value. Understood? Another example, x is equals to x plus 11, then x, then write the operator, then write the equal to symbol along with the constant. Is that clear? This is how the shorthand operator works. If it is n is equals to n into n divided by 10, then n is equals to n divided by 10 in this way. So whenever you are writing a expression, we are reducing the length of an expression. We are reducing the length of an expression using this shorthand operators. These shorthand operators are written using the arithmetic operators only, but in with that we are making use an assignment operator. So these are the shorthand operators. Then, after the shorthand operators, you have something called as conditional operators. Conditional operators. These are also called as ternary operators. Conditional operators are also called as ternary operators. Actually, to tell, operators are divided into three types. That is, unary operator, binary and ternary operator. Okay, unary operator here means will be acting only on a single variable. Binary operator will be acting on two variables. Whereas ternary, I mentioned ternary means three. It acts on three expressions or variables here. So the conditional operators work on three conditions here. The syntax means the rule of conditional operator is, first you are going to consider a condition with a question mark, and then expression 1 with the colon, it is expression 2. This is the syntax. First you have to consider condition, and here this question mark acts as the ternary operator. Okay, this condition, first condition, question mark with an expression 1, colon, even this is a ternary operator with expression 2. For example, if suppose 90%, okay, if the percentage you are taking is greater than 70, okay, if the percentage is greater than 70, then my expression is distinction, or it must be first class. This is my condition. Okay, this condition has to either match the first one or the second one. This will be the true condition and this is the false condition here. Okay, my condition is, if the percentage is greater than 70, question mark, if it is greater than 70, it should be either distinction or it must be first class. So based on this, the option will be selected. So if the condition is true, the result will be distinction. If the condition is false, the result will be first class. Suppose if I am entering the percentage as 50, 50 is greater than 70. My condition here is false. So the result I get is first class. Suppose if I am taking it as 80 greater than 70, then my result will be distinction. This is how the condition operator works. The condition operator works with the syntax as follows. First give the condition, then ternary operator, expression 1 with the colon and expression 2. You can give any number of expressions here. It is not compulsory, you have to give only 2. You can make use of any number of expressions. So this is the conditional operator, and it is also called as ternary operator. Is it clear? Conditional operator is also called as ternary operator. As I have already explained about assignment operator by telling about relational operator, I will just give the small definition, that's all. Assignment operator. This is also one type of operator I have mentioned. In the relation operator, we have seen double equal to symbol. So this is called as relational operator. Whereas coming to assignment operator, it is only single equal to. This is called as assignment operator. This is one mark question, which is the relation operator and assignment operator. For relation operator, you are writing double equal to. For assignment operator, you are writing the single equal to. The difference is, here in the relational operator, you are going to compare two values. When you want to compare two or more values, you make use of relational operator. That is, 2 is equal to 5. So comparing that whether 2 is equal to 5 or not, then it is not equal. So this is the relational operator here. Whereas coming to assignment operator is you are assigning a value to a variable. Like A is equal to 7, X is equal to 10, or X is equal to 10 by 5 in this way. So in this way you are going to assign a value to a variable. So when you are making use of single equal to, it means it is an assignment operator. Is that clear? It is an assignment operator and relation operator. So today I have revised logical operators like AND, OR and NOT, and then I have told what are shorthand operators, and I have told what is conditional operator and assignment operator. Still bitwise operator is left, and along with that other operators is left. So that I will be continuing tomorrow. Suppose in case if you have any doubt with these operators, you text me, I will revise it once again to you. Okay, thank you.